Good morning. It is Vlogmas. I say this every year, but I can't believe it's December again. As you can probably tell by the lighting, it's a very dreary morning. I'm all ready for the day, and once I've dropped Delilah off at school, I'm gonna head straight to the station because I thought it would be nice to go to London, do some Christmas shopping. A few weeks ago, just the two of us went to London for no reason other than just to go see some of the Christmas lights. We got some fresh donuts and sat and ate them by the fountains, and then we just mooched around the shops. I mean, it was a really nice day, and actually I forget how easy it is to get to London. It takes 40, 45, 50 minutes on the train. Doesn't cost too much more than if I were to get the bus into my local town centre. We ended up in Hamleys, which if you've not heard of Hamleys, is quite a big toy shop in London. There are quite a few things in there that Delilah pointed out. So yeah, I thought, you know what, let's go there and do some Christmas shopping. I usually end up doing everything online. I remember last year I went into town to do some Christmas shopping, and it wasn't very successful. I could barely find anything. I thought, you know what, there's lots of choice in London. Let's just go to London, do some Christmas shopping. Let's go look at all the Christmas lights. Thought it was the perfect way to begin Vlogmas. I planned to go yesterday. The weather forecast said it would be raining and sunny today, but it ended up being sunny yesterday and it's rainy today. Probably was no point in curling my hair this morning. I'm actually going to take some gloves as well, and it's probably the first time I've worn gloves all year. I'm hoping to be back on the train home by lunchtime. Going into Charing Cross, all the kind of main streets I want to go to, like Oxford Street, Carnaby, Soho, they're all within a sort of a 20-ish minute walk radius from the station, so I don't need to get on any tubes or anything. Just jump on the train, go to Charing Cross, do a few secret things. If I can find some bits for other people as well, if I see anything that I think, oh, so-and-so would like, then I'll grab those. But yeah, anyway, I'm excited. Let's turn the lights off. Let's get going.
London Charing Cross. This is due to a short platform. Thank
you. At London Charing Cross, in the interests of your safety and security. I love London this time of year. This was the Christmas market in Trafalgar Square that Delilah and I came to a few weekends ago. I'm just gonna make my way towards Carnaby Street area. That was a busy train in. Wasn't expecting it to be so busy. I assumed all the commuters would have gone earlier this morning. And when the train pulled up, the train station said, there's usually some seats on this train. Which made me think, ah, I think this is going to be a busy train, and it was. I just about got a seat. It feels really wintry today. I keep trying to vlog, but it's so loud. Or I have people right behind me. I've made my way to Soho. I was debating whether to walk to Oxford Street and go to Lush and get some bits there. Always get Delilah some bits from Lush for Christmas. But we have a Lush in our town, and I might as well wait until a bit later on in the month, just in case the bath bombs get a bit, you know, sometimes when they get a bit soft, and it's just extra stuff to carry, isn't it? So, but yeah, I'm gonna pop into Liberty, which is just down here. It's so nice coming here on a weekday morning, because when Delilah and I were here, it was heaving. And there's barely anyone down here. Oh my goodness, I did not know there was a store for Pleasin. Isn't this Harry Styles brand? It is, isn't it?
I don't think I can go in. It's an American Express members only, I think.
Yeah,
trade it into the
other
seat. Which door do I need? I think I want to go up one more. Oh, nope. One more. Up here should be the Christmas shop. This fills me with all the joy. We actually bought some ornaments in here when we came, so I don't have anything I need to get up here. But I thought I'd show you around as we're here, and it's the first Vlogmas. Let's have all the festive feels. Just come across some merry, merry dressing up bits. Delilah has this one. And she has this one. I don't know if she really needs any more dressing up, even though this is so gorgeous. Oh, they have the rifle paper, wrapping paper and gift bags. I've used the Nutcracker paper for Delilah a couple of years ago, and their mistletoe paper. They stock Moulin Roti, I think it's pronounced, which I usually end up buying bits from this brand for her birthdays and Christmases. I've picked up one of these Story flashlights. I might regret this, but I might grab her one of these harmonicas. And they have all the bits that I've bought her before. She's got the flower press. I got her that for her birthday. This set I bought around her birthday, but actually for Christmas. So that's been tucked away in the cupboard for all year. Such cute bits, but she doesn't need anything from here. I think everything on my to-get list is from Hamleys, really. Got a few bits in here for other people. Some wrapping paper and some stocking fillers. I bought her this one year as well for Christmas. It's a really cute sticker and colouring book. Time to go into Hamleys. When we came in here, someone did Delilah's nails with these nail kits. They're very cool. They've got sort of come with a reusable stamp. Trying to decide which set she would like. Got the goods. How cute are these candles? They've got Christmas tree ones and they've got wreath ones. Lunch. I might have time to sit down somewhere and find a spot for lunch rather than having it on the train. Oh no, I'm running out of battery, hang on. I might have a half charged battery in here. There we go. Oh, made a pigeon friend. I've got about 20 minutes until I need to get my train, so I've perched myself up here. I'm on these benches, well, concrete benches, chair things. It's feeling very wintry today. It's still really, really misty. It looks like they're setting up the Christmas tree. Looks like they're over there putting the lights on. I hunted down a Joe and the Juice. This is the tuna cardo sandwich. It's my favourite. I've not had it in such a long time. It might be 6 degrees, but I still got myself an iced coffee. So I'm gonna have that. This feels so festive. This has really got me in the Christmas mood. Thank you.
Delilah's currently upstairs in the bath. Dog's home too, so he's up there with her. I've had my hair tucked into this coat since about 8:30 this morning. How's it looking? Ooh, cute. Lovely and matted. Successful Christmas shopping trip. I got a little something for my dad. Got my Secret Santa sorted. Every year with Doug's family, we all draw names out of, well, we use a website to do it, but we all just have one person to do each year rather than all of us buying for everyone. So I've got my Secret Santa sorted. Everything else has been hidden away upstairs. The bits in here aren't actually bits I got today, but I thought I would show you them.
These are bits that Delilah and I got mostly. This isn't.
It's getting dark now. The lighting's gone all funny. This isn't from Liberty. I bought this online with some Christmas bits I got Delilah for her mouse house. Add it to the collection of mushroom tree ornaments. But these are the ornaments we picked up when we were in London. And we all know, hang on, these aren't. These are.
These were the bits that we bought in Liberty the other week. I couldn't see any of their felt ornaments today, so I don't know whether they've sold out in store. I think they still have them online. Anything I can link, I'll link in the description. We have quite a collection of dogs as well on our tree. I have this dog with a scarf and a hat on. Let's put him there. A pig with a Christmas pudding. Oh, I've only just noticed his tail. And a turtle dove. But we've ended up with so many dog ornaments over the years, just because a lot of felt animal ornaments tend to be dogs and they're really cute. So mix things up with the dove and the pig. In here are some other ornaments that I ordered online recently. Some more mushrooms. I bought 3 of them. They're in this kind of burnt orange velvet with beads. Thought these would be nice filler ornaments. Yeah, I thought I'd show you those now. All the other bits that I got today I will show you in my wrap with me video, like I usually do. So it wouldn't be Vlogmas without a wrap with me. This term Delilah's been doing forest school once a week at school. She comes out of school and it's on her face, in her hair, hence why she's back home and straight in the bath. Yeah, so I need to clean her wellies, pop them down here. And oh my goodness, and then these waterproofs. She has trousers and a jacket. They're from Muddy Puddles. They're great. We just went for the very plain navy set, but they do some really nice patterns. If you ever need a pair for school or forest school, I really recommend them. They wash well. I just stick them in the wash and they come out good as new.
She absolutely loves forest school. It's a shame that they're only doing it for the one term, but I guess they have to take it in turns with all the other years. One week she came back and she had somehow managed to get mud on the inside of these, so all her clothes were muddy too. I mean, I don't mind. It's a sign of a good time, isn't it?
Every year I forget the struggle with it getting dark so early and filming. I just never want to film once it's dark, because the way the lighting is in our rooms and where I put the camera, the lighting's always terrible. It feels so much later than it actually is. I think it's only about 5:30. I'm whizzing around the house getting some jobs done, doing my least favorite thing, which is putting washing away, and half the time it ends up left in this basket for, well, sometimes quite a long time. But yeah, I sorted Delilah's wardrobe out the other day, took out anything that was too small for her, so now it's much easier to get things back in her wardrobe. So yeah, it's not too much of a challenge putting everything away now. I have my peppermint tea. My tummy's having a bit of a moment at the moment. It's just a little bit aggravated, and I'm having a peppermint tea in the hopes that it helps to settle it. There never seems to be a rhyme or reason as to why sometimes my tummy plays up and why other times it doesn't. Now it's December, this will be the only mug that I drink from for the rest of the month, even though we have several others downstairs and that one needs hand washing, and I will end up just rewashing that same mug because I really like it. So I've got to make the most of using it this month. I'm gonna take my hair out. I had my hair cut the other day and I did that thing where it'd been quite a while since I'd had it cut, and I was a bit too, I played on the safe side. I didn't want to get too much cut off. This always happens. And then I realise I actually want more cut off than I had, and so I end up going back a month or two later, and then I get enough off and then I'm happy with it for a few months and then repeat the cycle. I'm gonna go see where Delilah is at because I need to go do her hair. I think she's in the bedroom reading her school book with Doug. Actually, whilst I do that, I'm going to get some dinner bits together. We have these little rainbow carrots to use up, so I'm thinking I'm going to roast those. I've got some green beans, a random assortment of potatoes that I'm going to mash, and some sausages, and of course we've got to have it with some Bisto.
What are you cooking, me? What are you cooking, good looking?
Hey,
what are you cooking?
Sausages and mash.
She's ready for hair drying.
Okay, I'm feeling really conscious of my nose. I just see, looking at myself in the viewfinder, I can't really tell. You can see a little bit of a bump here. I don't know what it is. I woke up with it yesterday or the day before. It was really sore. It's not too sore anymore. I filmed some partnerships for Instagram yesterday, and then when I was editing them, it made my nose look really wonky and I didn't realise how obvious it was. Teeny tiniest carrot. And end the vlog here because you know the drill by now. I'm gonna take my makeup off. We're gonna have dinner. I'm gonna watch TV. I'm gonna go to bed. I hope you enjoyed the first Vlogmas of this year. Really looking forward to Vlogmas this year. I mean, I always do, but yeah, really feeling in the festive spirit after today. Anyway, I'm going off on a tangent now. Our dinner is done and I'm going to take my makeup off. I just wanted to say thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Oh, and for those of you who aren't familiar with Vlogmas, or at least familiar with maybe my Vlogmas, the aim is to upload every other day until Christmas. Because of birthday plans, I'm not quite sure how it's going to work out this year. Whether there'll be less vlogs or I'll have to just pre-film some more vlogs, or I'm not, I'll figure it out. I think that's everything I was going to say. Thanks for watching, and I will see you for the next Vlogmas in a couple of days.